Hey guys, it is Tyler here, back once again, another weekly ramble. Sorry I missed last week and almost this week. It's kind of been like 2-3 full weeks just because I've been moving, all that stuff's going on, so haven't done really any videos at all since all the Desmond Sun stuff, Subject 16 stuff, yada yada yada, you've all heard the nonsense. So back now, all set up in my new apartment, good to go with videos again, so here we are. I did a poll for what topic people wanted me to talk about, but I mean it was quite even, and the winner was AC Multiplayer Returning, or I'm pretty sure, the poll hasn't even finished by the time I'm recording this, but I don't really want to, I can do a separate video on that, because I talked about that on Kill Connor Clubhouse this past week, so I'll do another video talking about this. It won't be a weekly ramble, it'll be a, you know, a different sort of video, because I wanted to do something else. Even once I put the poll out, I realized that I actually wanted to do one of these topics. But there's two I actually really wanted to do. And it was more about life rather than Assassin's Creed. I wanted to sit here and ramble on about life and things and have multiplayer gameplay going on over it. And there was two topics. What do I study and why? Which I probably will do next week. I might record it all at once, maybe, I don't know. And then getting motivated in life. And I think it's important because it's something people message me about fairly often. About, I mean, whether it's about YouTube, starting up like a YouTube channel, motivation just in general, or feeling down, or they like hearing me talk about what I do because it motivates them. Stuff like that. It's quite interesting. And I thought, you know, I'm a very self-motivated guy. Always have been my entire life. I've been lucky enough, and I've worked hard enough that I've got to do a lot of amazing things, and that's mostly outside of YouTube. YouTube barely comes into that, but YouTube is definitely an aspect of things. I've done some crazy shit I never expected I'd be able to do, but it's something I think is worth talking about. I think I might even be able to have some things to say that might help some people, I don't know, but people have talked to me about it and seem to want to hear it for a long time. When I talk about things like Kill Connor Club, and I go into those deep and meaningful sorts of rambles that I have, and I thought, well, this is the weekly ramble, this is just my own space to ramble on about shit. What a perfect topic to do it, to get deep into shit I like to talk about in life. And being motivated, I mean, there's the most important thing about it to me is wanting something. There's two main aspects to it. One, it's everything you do, every day in life, the way you live your life, the way you leave your room, how clean it is, how tidy it is, the way you leave your house, the way you dress, it's not about there's anything wrong with everyone should dress this way, everyone should do this, but it's like the way you portray yourself, the way you feel about yourself is an extension of how you live your life, and it's how your mind, an extension of your mindset. And the other thing comes as well to wanting to do something. So about being motivated, I find that when I have my life, I don't know, together, but, you know, my apartment's clean, my hair's cut, I'm dressed the way I want, like, I feel when I'm put together is when I'm feeling the best and most motivated. It's hard to explain. But when you have all those little things working for you, or just the way you do things in your life, everything else kind of flows with it. Everything, your mindset is clearer, and it gives you that opportunity to go and do things that are using your mindset that you have. It's hard to explain, but this is what the weekly ramble is, right? It's just rambling. What I'm trying to say is, I mean, for me, so, I mean, what do I study? I study film. I've wanted to make movies and be a film director since I was 6 years old. I've always been self-motivated because I've always had a goal. And, you know, 15 years later, I still want to do that. Nothing has changed in my life. I still want to make movies. I still want to be a film director. I want to do other things as well. Certainly, there's a lot of other things I want to do on top of that as a life goal, but that life goal's always been there, and everything I've done since I was 6 has been working towards that goal. So I've been lucky enough to have something I've wanted to do so much, and people have told me, you know, that's unrealistic, you're not going to do it, blah, 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 and I've always told them, since I was 6 years old, watch me do it, I don't give a fuck, I'm going to do it anyway, and here I am, 21, 22 this year, final year of university, studying film, having the opportunity to be a content creator on YouTube, you know, minorly successfully, and make my own short film series, be writing films, be involved with a lot of cool people in my life, whether it's content creators on YouTube, whether it's filmmakers and writers in life, in at university or in or the workforce. I've had a lot of amazing opportunities to work with a lot of crazy people that I never thought I'd get to work with, and talk to people I never thought I'd get to talk to, and I'm just getting started, and this is just the most minor little prologue chapter of my journey, is what I feel. It's only going to grow exponentially from here, and I know that, because I've always had that mindset and told myself, well, I'm going to do it, I don't give a shit what anyone says to me, this is what I want to do, this is what I'm going to do. Anyone that tells me no, anyone that tells me I can't do it, I like that more, because it just makes you want to do it more. It's harder when you have, I mean, I'm lucky as well, because it depends on the people doing it. If it's just a friend or a general person saying, I don't think you're going to do it, well, it's like, well, watch me, and you don't really want to hang out with them anymore. And you're like, well, you can't be my friend, because you don't believe in me. That's what friends are supposed to do. Friends are supposed to build you up. When your friends say that sort of shit to you, well, for sure, they're not your friend, and none of my friends that I have would ever say that to me. They all believe in me, the same way I believe in them when they want to do something. You know, friends are supposed to build each other up. When it's your family, it's different. I'm lucky. My family's always supported me. They've always been realistic, and they've always, and it's never been to push me back from what I want to do. But they've kind of helped guide me to make sure if I'm going to do this, do it the right way, I guess, or do it the realistic way where you have to do things you don't want to do. You have to make sacrifices, you have to work harder than you ever thought you could, you have to do things you just don't like. But at the end of the day, you will succeed by doing that sort of stuff. So having those goals in life that I've always had have always helped keep me motivated. And when there's times where I'm down and I'm unmotivated and things aren't going my way, that's when you need to work hardest the most. Because when things are good, holy shit, they're going to get even crazier. But if you're not doing anything, then nothing's going to work out for you. My favorite saying, and this is from Coach Kavanaugh. He's the coach of Conor McGregor, the UFC fighter. He has a book out called Win or Learn. And that's one of the best sayings I've ever heard in my life. I've always lived by it, but I never had a word for it. It's you either win or you learn. So that means is when you do something, when you actually try, you either win and you succeed, or you learn. There's no win or lose. If you are doing something, you're attempting something, you're learning, you're growing as a person, you can't lose. The only way you can lose in life is by not doing something. You can fuck up and it can hurt you, but you did not lose. You learnt. Everything you do is a journey. Everything you do is a lesson. Everything you do helps you grow as a human being. So by always going out and making sure you're trying new things, you're like, you know, I'll give you an example. I did stand-up comedy last year, the start of last year. I was really into it. I just got obsessed with it. It wasn't something I wanted to do for a career or anything. I just was like, I really want to try stand-up. And I got obsessed with it. I started thinking about it a lot. I started going to open mic nights just to see what the Melbourne comedy scene was like. It's huge here. And just watching and watch people do those open mic nights, just amateurs. And then I wrote my own thing and I just got up and did it. I've done it a few times, and it was kind of out of my system. I didn't really want to keep doing it. I'd like to maybe do it another few times later on down the line when I have some, like a joke or a set written that I'd like to do, but it was just like, my mindset going up to it was, I just want to do it, so why not? What's the worst thing that can happen? You know, people always say that stand-up's one of the scariest things ever, and I'm like, I completely disagree. For me, anyway, because public speaking is like my favorite thing in the world. As you probably all know by now, I just love to fucking talk my, you know, your ears off. But there was no losing that situation. By actually doing it, I either fucked up and people wouldn't laugh. Oh, well, let's try again and see if I can make people laugh. Or people laugh and it goes really well and that's awesome. And it had times where, like, the first time I did it, lots of people laughed. It went really well. I was like, holy shit, that was awesome. Next time I went up, no one laughed. It was fucking horrendous. But I love that just as much because I got to learn from it. Your mindset shouldn't be, oh, I'm kicking myself, no one laughed. I'm like, fuck, that was excellent. Like, I saw what didn't work, and I can move things around and flow better, and I learned from experience of having to deal with that sort of pressure of no one laughing, because it was a different pressure when I was up there. and I like that. So the only time I could lose was if I never went and did it. I went and watched those open mic nights. I thought, I want to do it. And then I was like, oh God, I just don't want to go. But I'm too scared. I don't have the guts. And I just never did it. I would have regretted that. That's a loss. That's a complete loss. Waste of my time. What's wrong with me? Just do it knowing it's the mindset you have going into everything, right? I think motivation is mindset. It's always about keeping busy. The main thing I think anyone can do is keep busy always in your life. For example, I find the people that, I know this is, I'm going off on tangents and whatnot, but this is, it is what it is. You know, when it comes to the win or learn thing, always, my main thing to take away from, always try. Your mindset should be to always, always make an effort. Always try, and you can only win from trying. You cannot lose. There is no way you can lose. Things can fuck up and you can feel bad and you can feel regret, but that's not a loss. That's a learning experience. And you know, and you can tell yourself after that, fuck, I'm never doing that again. I'm not going to do it that way again. Oh shit, that didn't work out. I'm not going to make that mistake again. Not that you're never going to do it again, but you're never going to make that mistake again, I should say. And when it comes to just being motivated in life in general, the main thing is to always keep busy. Things like depression, that comes from things like sleeping in a lot, not getting up early, staying in bed a lot of the day, just playing video games, not making any effort. This, I can still play video games in my day, right? But this is like a best way to still stay motivated, still feel like I'm doing something and keep your mind healthy, is to get up, not sit in bed. I mean, just get up, have a shower, have a coffee, have some breakfast, have some food, get everything sorted. You're feeling ready, you know, you're dressed, your hair's done, you're ready to go with your day. But I don't need to be anywhere till 12, I've got something to do. So I'm going to play an hour of video games, and I might make a YouTube video and record something, right? I'm still, know I'm going to do something that day, but I'm going to play some video games in the morning, but I'm ready to go with my day. I'm not lazing around, and then all of a sudden, like, shit, I got to go to this thing at 12, I better shower, I better do this, and you're in a rush, and then your mind's in a rush, and then everything in your whole day kind of gets fucked up. Or to just not be doing anything. For example, talking to someone at my work, they only work 2 days a week. And I'll work 5. And they tell me, fuck, I hate coming to work. I just can't be bothered coming to work. And then I might do a week where I've only done 2-3 days, right? I feel the same way. If I work 5 days a week, I find that's better and easier to do than working 2 days a week. Because when you've got all that time off, it's harder to push yourself to come into work. When you're working 5 days, it's just a consistent mindset. It's easier to enjoy life. It is easier to for your mind to deal with doing things when you're always doing things, when you're always busy. Obviously, you need some rest time in there, but that's fine. Like I said, give yourself that time, but don't sit around lazily. Get yourself ready. Then sit down, play an hour of video games, play 2 hours of video games. And when you finish your day, it's more satisfying for me to play, like, literally binge video games, like, 3-4 hours. It's way better for me to do that at night or something when I've achieved something that day. Even on a lazy day. So I've got some time off at the moment. And I'm literally have not stopped. I've got 2 weeks off before I start uni. And I've taken 2 weeks off work, I should say. Because even though, you know, I've been off uni for 3 months, during that time I'm working still 5-6 days a week, right? I'm busy as fuck. And I'm trying to catch up on other things in life. Now I've got taken 2 weeks off work before uni goes back, so then I'll go back to uni work and the year begins. Because I want to be able to, obviously, move apartments, re-energize, you know, get new clothes, I had to get new shoes, like, do things like that I need to catch up on, go to the dentist, and just, you know, repair my mind, recover. But I haven't stopped doing anything. Every single day I've been doing stuff, whether it's building furniture, whether it's going out and shopping for things I need, whether it's, you know, catching up on some appointments, catching up with a friend, doing something, for me, it'll be like YouTube channel stuff and everything. I haven't stopped, but I'm still mentally recovering by not being at work the whole time, doing some different things. And there needs to be some rest time in there, right? So today, for example, I've got really nothing to do. I'm going to go out tonight, and that's all I had to do that day. But this morning, first thing I did is I got up, had a shower, got dressed, made some coffee, watched the news. And then I came in to my room, and I, said, I'm going to sit down and play some video games, maybe, but I'm going to record this video first, and then I'm going to do some editing. And even though I'm not, I'm not, you know, doing a big day. I'm not going to work. I'm not doing anything. I feel like I've achieved something, or I just feel better in myself because I feel ready to go with my day. That if I got a phone call right now, oh, Tyler, want to do this, blah, 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 I could do it right now. I could go outside right now and do anything I want to do. I feel like I could do anything I want to do right now. And that's a different way to have your mindset of when you're sitting in your underwear because you haven't been bothered to get up and have a shower. It's just the simple things in life to help your mind feel healthier. It's the simple things in life like that to keep yourself motivated, to keep your brain active, to keep your body feeling active and healthy. That's the best way to be motivated, to do anything. Because I feel like I can right now do anything just because I'm not sitting in my underwear because I've sat up and haven't been bothered to do anything. And I'd feel like I went off on that tangent. It's been longer than I expected this ramble to go, but I'm okay. I'm okay for it to go this long. I actually kind of like this. I'm enjoying this. What I wanted to say was, like, it feels better to play and binge those video games or something if I've, for something like today, I've just gotten up, recorded some videos, made sure I was ready to go with my day. I went to the gym. That's not a big effort day, but I did things I had to do, kept active. Now tonight I'm going to play 3-4 hours of video games, and I can do that guilt-free. I don't feel like I've wasted a day. I've, you know, done things I had to do. I've checked my emails. I've made sure all my business stuff, everything's, you know, going fine. That's it. I've made sure life's okay. I've done things I had to do. Now let's play some video games. And I enjoy it way more than if I just got up and played video games for 4 hours. Because sure, it's fun to do those and play those video games, but I have this weird regret and guilt, real deep, that I just am like, oh God, I can't get it in the back of my mind. And that isn't there when I make sure I do everything and make sure life's going. And the best way to be motivated, the best way to keep, I think, mentally, physically, emotionally healthy is to be active. Don't sit on your ass when you wake up in the morning. Don't just be lazy, I guess I don't know if there's the right way to put it, but it's just about the simple things. Even if you've got nothing to do in the day, first thing you should do is get up, have a shower, have something to eat, and just feel like you could go outside if you had to right now. But if you're not, oh, I feel like doing this for now, I feel like blah, 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 you can, it's not a big deal, but just be aware, be awake in the world, be aware of the world, get up is the best start, is the simplest thing, and to keep busy, give yourself stuff to do, and when you have a goal, like I was talking about when I started, if you have a big goal in life like I do, my whole life has that sort of setup and always has since I was 6 to want to do that sort of goal. But I have so many little goals, whether it's a goal I have for today, or it's a goal I have this week, or if it's a goal I have this month. Set yourself goals for the week, the month, write lists down of things you want to achieve today. The first thing I did on my first day off of work for these 2 weeks of holiday, I wrote a list, a big list of things I want to achieve before I go back. Big list of stuff I want to do. And I've already done half of it. I've only been off for 3 days or 4 days or something. Because I just want to do that. I want to get all that out of the way. And the rest is like YouTube stuff. And now I get to enjoy the fun stuff. I got the shitty stuff out of the way. The business stuff out of the way. The home moving stuff out of the way. I'm doing the fun stuff now. I'm going to record some videos. I'm going to talk to you guys. I'm going to do these rambles. And I've really enjoyed this ramble. It's way longer than it's supposed to be. But I actually love talking about this sort of stuff. It's really important to me. And I think people need to hear this sort of thing. Because I'm older than a lot of people that listen. Assassin's Creed is a bit of a younger audience. I mean, I'm a very young guy. I got a lot to learn, a lot to achieve, and it's all about knowing and being aware that I don't know everything, but I know I can help some people with some advice, and I know I'm always been a self-motivated guy. I know for my age, I've done a lot of stuff, and I know I'm successful, and I'm going to be successful. It's not arrogance. It's just what the fact of the matter is. I know that's what I'm going to do. I've always been that sort of person, and I'm always going to be that sort of person. That's how I live my life, and that's how I'm going to continue to live my life. I think I've said everything I wanted to say. I don't really know. Again, these are the rambles. Sometimes I'll think later on, shit, I wanted to say that and I didn't. But it is what it is. There's no editing. It's just this. It's just me talking to you guys. And I hope maybe this helps some of you out. Or if it's just you got an insight into me and my mindset. Either way, I do hope you enjoyed this ramble and enjoyed, I think, this multiplayer gameplay is probably what I'll put underneath it. This is what it's going to be. I want the rambles to be, I think, more now, less about specific topics on Assassin's Creed. I can do a different video on that topic of Assassin's Creed. The rambles are multiplayer gameplay with me talking about life, me talking about stuff going on with me talking about an important topic whether it's advice, whether it's just in general. I'm not going to fucking sit here and talk about bullshit politics or any of that nonsense. Like, I'm not here to cause an argument or debate. I don't want to use my energy for that sort of nonsense on this channel. I want to use it for helping people out with things they want help for. So if you want to leave comments of things you'd like me to talk about in the next video, please go ahead and do it. I'd love that. If you have any issues going on at the moment, you're like, oh, I wonder what Tyler would think of that. Let me know, and I'll have a chat about it. And maybe I've had an experience of something similar myself. I'm here to be open and talk about anything to you guys. I'm not going to be a closed book here. I'm happy to go deep into some personal shit if we have to, if that helps people out. Because, you know, I'm happy to talk about anything. Anyway, that's this ramble, guys. Way longer than they're supposed to be. I don't expect them to all be this long, but I felt like this was an important topic and I just enjoyed going on and on and on. So guys, thank you very much for listening, if you're here for the whole thing. You probably, I imagine, enjoyed this, and for sure, like the video, subscribe to the channel if you're new, and I will see you very soon, guys, for the next video and the next ramble. Bye!